Hi everyone, sorry it's been a while since my last video of making data engineering a breeze. If you work with streaming and big data technologies such as Apache Kafka, Kubernetes, Splunk, check out my videos in the channel. And remember to click on the thumbs up and subscribe to support us. So today we're going to be talking about how you can define your streaming data pipelines with nothing but declarative configuration and managing them via GitOps. Now managing your pipelines in this way is going to massively simplify how you can port across different environments. By having everything as configuration in Git is going to add a layer of consistency and governance to how you manage your deployments. Like many of my videos, I'm going to use Lenses.io, pointing to an instance of Kafka and Kubernetes. Firstly, I'm going to build a pipeline locally on my machine by creating two topics, a stream processing application between the two topics, and then sending the data onwards to an instance of InfluxDB via Kafka Connect. Once I've created the pipeline, we're going to export everything as configuration using the Lenses CLI client, push it into Git, merge into master branch, and then again use the Lenses CLI client to import into a completely different environment. So let's take a quick look. So I want to go ahead and create that pipeline locally on my machine. And to do that, I'm going to use a free instance of Lenses.io pointing to its own Kafka environment as a single container. You can download it for free. And when you run it and launch it for the first time, you'll notice it has a pre-configured state. So some example streams, and if we go into the topology view, you'll notice it has some example pipelines. So let's not worry about that. Let's go ahead and create those two topics as part of that pipeline. Now you can either do that in the topics section here, or a more powerful way is if you go into the SQL Studio and you can define your topics using SQL commands. So here I'm just going to create two topics, one called customers and one called customers older than 18. And it's going to go ahead and create the schema associated with those two topics automatically. Now if you go back into the topics section, you'll notice those two topics have been created correctly in Kafka. Now we want to go ahead and create that stream processing application between those two topics. So Lenses allows you to define applications using a SQL syntax. So here's a really basic example of where we're selecting all the fields from the customer's topic and just filtering where the age is greater than 17. And that's going to populate the customer's older than 18 topic. Now if you go ahead and save that on a Lenses box, it's going to run locally, but in a real environment, you can choose to deploy that over your Kubernetes cluster. Now, if we go back into the topology view, we're starting to see our pipeline being built out, that customer's topic, the stream processing application, and then out to the customer's older than 18 topic. Now, the final piece of our pipeline is creating that data integration into InfluxDB. And we're going to do this via Kafka Connect, using Lenses to configure that connector. Now, anyone familiar with Kafka Connect may recognize some of these settings. There's one thing that's unique to the way Lenses deploys the connectors is it allows you to define via SQL how you're going to map to the target system. So here's an example of a select command that's going to just map two fields to a table within InfluxDB. And if we go ahead and create that connector, that's going to deploy over your Kafka Connect cluster. Now, if we go back into the topology view, we see our pipeline fully built out. Those two topics, the stream processing application, and then out to InfluxDB. So that's our pipeline built, but there's just maybe one more thing I want to do before exporting the configuration. That's just to quickly test if it works. Now, obviously, this is just running locally on my machine, so I don't actually have any live data, but we can use Lenses to inject some data as a unit test into Kafka just to see what comes out at the end. Now, there are a few different ways of producing data into Kafka via Lenses. One way is back in that SQL Studio with SQL insert commands. So here I'm just going to paste in a SQL statement, which is going to inject four events into that customer's topic. So if we go back into the topics section and look for our two topics, we see four records in that customer's topic and then two records in that customer's older than 18. And if we drill down, once again, using a SQL command, we see two events correctly inserted into that customer's older than 18. And if we want to double check to see if the data's got into InfluxDB, and we see those two events that have been populated through the Kafka Connect connector. Now that we're sure our pipeline works, we can start exporting it into configuration.
Now, lenses provides a Go client which allows you to export the state or the application landscape. Now, here I have a little script using the CLI client, which is going to export a number of objects, including the schemas, the topics, those connectors, those applications I created. And if I just run locally an ls command, we see there's nothing in the directory. Now let's run my export script. And the script has correctly created a number of directories which represent different Kafka objects, if you like. If we quickly want to check one of the files, let's take, for example, the connector to InfluxDB that we created earlier. There's our YAML file with all the configuration. Now, of course, we want to push this to Git. Now, here I'm on a branch, new pipeline 2. Let's go ahead and commit that and then push that to the remote server. If we jump into Git, there's our pipeline. Let's just create a merge request. And I'm just going to immediately merge that into the master branch. But of course, the benefit of having everything as configuration is it makes it super easy to review. Now we're going to want to jump into a completely different environment. Now this is a pre-production instance of lenses pointing to a completely different Kafka and Kubernetes cluster. If we go into the topology view, we don't see that pipeline that we created on my local machine. That's to be expected. Now, if we terminal into the pre-production lenses environment, we're going to use the lenses CLI client, except this time we're going to use an import function. But first we need to pull the master branch from the remote server. Now we see those same directories that we saw on my local machine. Let's just run that import script. And obviously you'd probably want to automate this. And now if we jump back into the lenses pre-production environment, check the topology view. And there we go, our pipeline, the two topics, the stream processing application, and then the connector into InfluxDB. How magic was that?
Okay, that's it for this video. Some links in the details below. Thanks for watching, and bye.